Good evening, everybody. We'll be discussing public interest litigation today. मुझे दिशा ने strict instructions दिए थे राम सर। Am I audible?
I'm audible.
So दिशा gave me strict instructions that I'm only supposed to deal with the practical aspect of this subject. So some of the issues that I'll be touching upon will be how do you file a PIL, आप notice reporting और फाइलिंग कैसे करवाते हैं एंड व्हाट ऑल कंटेंट्स मस्ट बी देयर इन योर पीआईएल पेटिशन ऑलराइट सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द इश्यूज दैट आई विल बी टचिंग अपॉन बिफोर यू ऑल लीव दिस क्लास आई वांट यू टू हैव अ बेसिक अंडरस्टैंडिंग इन दिस एरिया ऑफ सम बेसिक इश्यूज यू नीड टू नो ऑलराइट सो पीआईएल एज अ मैकेनिज्म इन माई व्यू हैज बीन ओवरयूज्ड As a process, it has been abused, and there's no doubt in my mind about this. But आप देखें तो आज आज हर एक issue पे, छोटे से छोटे issue पे, people file a PIL. Even for the drop of a hat, people file a PIL. For instance, if you do not want the Indian cricket team to go and play Pakistan, so all you have to do is go and file a PIL. If you don't like what the Prime Minister of the country says in a foreign country. And you want to restrain him from doing that, go and file a PIL. If you can't digest the fact that people watched adult movies at home and you want to restrain them from doing that, you file a PIL. अगर आपको लगता है अच्छे दिन नहीं आए, file a PIL and you petition the government. So PIL is being filed for every small issue that we can think of. And partially, the courts are also to be blamed for this. Many a times courts have also entertained frivolous petitions and not only entertained them but ended up passing detailed orders. I don't know if you know this but Kerala High Court ki ek elaborate judgment hai on how to control mosquitoes. Karnataka High Court went one step ahead and they laid down the parameters as to how a beauty contest must be judged. Allahabad High Court last year gave to itself this task of beautifying a public park and the kind of orders that were passed comprised of isme kaun sa fountain lagega kis size ka fountain hoga kis tarah ke paudhe kis color ke paudhe honge kaun sa musical band shaam mein aake perform karega so these kind of orders are being passed and the court has begun to intervene in areas where it would not have let's say perhaps 15 years back so The essential point I'm trying to convey is that PIL is being filed for every issue these days. Now, PIL as a concept emerged post a constitutional crisis. Can anybody tell me what that constitutional crisis was that I'm referring to? Right. So when the Supreme Court was asked to defend civil liberties in the infamous case of ADM Jabalpur, and they miserably failed. There was merciless criticism of the Indian judiciary, and people completely lost confidence. So, in this backdrop, PIL as a concept was brought into life. So, it was in this backdrop that PIL as a concept emerged, and there were some judges of the Supreme Court, including Justice Bhagwati, Justice Iyer, Justice Chinnappa Reddy, Justice Desai. Who gave themselves this task of redeeming the image of the Indian judiciary? And yes, their efforts did fructify into something because if 30 years down the line, if there is one wing of the state which will shout at the top of its voice whenever there is an infraction of fundamental rights, it is the judiciary, not the executive, not the parliament or the legislative assembly. It is the judiciary. So that lost confidence has been won. Now let's. Discuss a little bit about PIL. So I hope everybody knows where can a PIL be filed. I mean, it's only the High Court and the Supreme Court who have jurisdiction to entertain PIL matters. अगर आपने Jolly LB movie देखी थी तो उसमें थोड़ा सा कुछ अलग दिखाया गया है. But yeah, so you can't file a PIL in a district court. Anything similar to a PIL which can be filed in the lower court. Is a complaint under section 133 of CRPC where you can allege public nuisance But it's not really similar to a PIL because the kind of issues that you can agitate in a PIL are very wide. So a PIL can only be filed in the Supreme Court and the High Court.
So Section 80 of CPC is also similar to that.
Section 80 of CPC?
Yeah.
What does 80 say?
Wrongful effects, wrongful deeds affecting the public.
Alright, so no, see, even IPC has a section on public nuisance. Alright, but then, like I said, the kind of issues that you can agitate in a PIL, the issues which I just pointed out when I started, you see, you can agitate any issue in a PIL. Right, aapko kuch bhi nahi pasand hai, you go and file a PIL. So that's a little different, alright? So PIL can only be filed in the High Court and Supreme Court, and both have original jurisdiction and concurrent at the same time. So it's not as if you go to the Supreme Court first, then the Supreme Court will tell you go to the High Court and then come to us. Aap ya to Supreme Court jaiye or ya to High Court jaiye. My humble advice would be that you go to the High Court first, because there you will get more time to argue. Now, there are some ways which I wanted to discuss in which a PIL matter can be heard by a court of law. First is suo motu cognizance. This is where, let's say, the court is in session of certain facts, or certain facts come to the knowledge of the court and they themselves initiate a PIL. And naturally, once they initiate a PIL on their own, the infractor or the violator becomes a party to the proceedings and proceedings begin. So this is one way where the court can on its own take cognizance. Sometimes the Supreme Court can also take cognizance and send the matter to the High Court. And then the High Court will initiate a PIL. This is done basically in those situations where the High Court would be better equipped to deal with that matter. So this is one way. The second way could be where you write a letter addressing it to the Chief Justice of India or the Chief Justice of the High Court. And then perhaps your letter will be converted into a PIL petition. The moment it gets converted into a PIL petition, it becomes a regular PIL matter. But there's a caveat. You must not try doing this for the simple reason that the courts are overburdened with regular PIL matters. They just do not have the time to deal with your letter petition. So until and unless you are a top bureaucrat or an ex-CJ or an ex-judge of the High Court, I don't really think your letter petition will ever get accepted. The court just doesn't have time for this. Like I said, people file PILs for everything. I recall when I was in second year, I counted how many rights have been carved out from Article 21 itself up till now. And I counted, there are around 28 fundamental rights which have been carved out from Article 21 itself. And this is only one fundamental right. So imagine how Article 14 has gotten treated in other articles. There are so fundamental rights that somebody has approached the court alleging violation of some fundamental right or the other. So regular PIL matters is what the court focuses on and not these PIL petitions. So the second was where you invoke the epistolary jurisdiction of the court. This is a letter PIL. Third is what we talk about. It's a regular PIL matter. Now, can anybody tell me what is the difference between an ordinary writ petition and a PIL petition? Anybody?
In ordinary PIL, ordinary writ, you argue that my own right has been violated. And in PIL, you take a locus standi on basis of general
public. You're absolutely right. Basically, the concept of locus standi in a PIL petition gets completely relaxed. So you are never questioned.
What is your standing to stand?
Whether you are aggrieved or not. So this is the main difference between a regular PIL matter and an ordinary writ petition. But let's say in the garb of public interest, you file a personally motivated PIL petition. Let me give you an example. For example, I want to set up a biomedical waste plant in Lucknow. And I need to seek permission from the State Pollution Control Board and the municipality as well, let's say. And both of them deny me permission. Pursuant to this, I file a motivated petition in the court alleging financial irregularity in the municipality as well as the pollution control board. Aap bataiye, how does the court prevent this? How will the court know that this is personally motivated? And how do they somehow put a check on this activity? So the first issue that we discussed was local standby. Second issue is, the court prevents this by asking you to make a mandatory disclosure. What is a disclosure? A disclosure basically is where you state on affidavit that you are filing this writ petition in public interest, right? And also you bring to the knowledge of the court certain facts which are necessary for adjudication. For example, let's consider this example only, which I gave you. Maan lijiye, there is financial irregularity in PCB and as a result, I was a victim of it. So can I as a citizen of India not go to the court alleging financial irregularities or nepotism? Of course I can. But then I have to disclose this fact to the court that I was a victim. So this means that your petition is not motivated. So for that, a disclosure is very important. I'm telling you, your petition will never get admitted if you do not make a disclosure. I have seen petitions filed by ex-DGPs, ex-bureaucrats and ex-professors being dismissed in limine just because there was no disclosure. Basically, these are Supreme Court guidelines in the Balwant Mehta case which have got incorporated in the rules of the court. You understand, every high court has certain rules which it is governed by. So these guidelines are there in the rules of the court that you have to mandatorily make a disclosure. And in a disclosure, you have to state all this, that you've come to the court with clean hands, this petition is not personally motivated, and everything, every fact that you are supposed to bring to the knowledge of the court. Alright, so this is about disclosure. Third point is including the correct parties. For example, you understand that a PIL is usually filed against the state or an instrumentality of the state. You can't file it against a private person. You can make private person a party, but then you have to make the state also a party because the state will prevent that private person from infringing upon your rights. So you have to make that private person also a party, but along with the state. So including the correct party is very important. For example, you go to the court alleging environmental degradation. So whom do you make a party? In this case, you have to make the pollution control board a party, either the state or the center. Perhaps you can also make municipality the party in case there was a duty upon them which they were not obeying. Then you also make Ministry of Environment and Forest a party. So these are some of the parties which you will have to implead. So for example, maan lijiye, if you go to the court alleging law and order deterioration in your city, let's say in the city of Lucknow, so will you make municipality the party? Of course not. Who do you make a party? Who? Yeah, you. I guess you're right.
Huh? DGP.
Alright, you make perhaps the DM the party because district magistrate is responsible for law and order situation. Perhaps the commissioner of that division. Then you also make principal secretary home a party and also the superintendent of police of that area. So these are some of the parties you have to implead. Alright. So for example, let's say I want to file a PIL against this university or let's say the Kanpur University. And whom do I make a party? Right. The Vice Chancellor, the Chancellor perhaps. Let's say that, yeah, if there's some financial irregularity in the management, then you also make the registrar a party. Then somebody from the higher education department. So this is how you go about impleading the parties. And it's really important that you implead the correct parties. Otherwise your matter will not get heard. You'll get an adjournment or you'll be given a future date. Because you see, every PIL matter is taken up either by the Chief Justice of the court or the senior most judge of the court. So these judges will not pass ex parte orders. They will definitely hear the other side before passing an order. They will not infract principles of natural justice. So aapko ye cheez thoda dhyan rakhni that you implead the correct parties. Otherwise your matter will not get heard. Now, once you implead the correct parties, then you have to draft your petition. Pleading aapko karni hoti hai, you have to be a little careful with that. You can't just go to a court of law and say anything that you want. The court often asks you, tell us where you've stated this. So you have to show to the court that you have pleaded this. Right? For example, you allege, let's say, poor law and order situation in your city. So you have to, let's say, not only plead this, but also give certain evidence of it. So you have to annex certain, let's say, report which suggests the same, koi newspaper article or newspaper cutting, or koi aise maan lijiye NCRB ka koi data hua. So you have to show to the court that this is what you rely upon. The court does not pass orders on the basis of surmises and conjectures. So the court also needs certain facts before it. And therefore it's very important that you plead everything. And then when you draft your prayer, it's very important that you ask for everything. For instance, let's say a government order which has passed. Let's say there's some GO which has been passed and you claim that it infracts your fundamental rights. Alright, so it's very important that you ask for a stay on that order. Otherwise the court can refuse to grant you a stay because you've not prayed for it. So you have to pray for everything. The court of course has discretion to go beyond your prayer. But then the court can also refuse a particular prayer if you've not prayed for it in your petition. So you have to be a little careful while pleading. Both is pleading. Now, here's some tips. I believe whenever you file a PIL, you must always file it as a group. Let's say 7 to 8 of you get together and file it. Or you get together with an NGO and then file it. Whenever you file it as a group, the court is also aware of the fact that a group has come to the court. Perhaps this distinguishes your PIL from ordinary PIL matters. It's not necessary that you'll always get a favorable order, but sometimes you may. So always file it as a group. And this is my sincere advice to all of you, that if you want to file a PIL in a court of law, you must always file it in person. What does this mean? That you go and argue the case yourself. You don't hire a lawyer. For the simple reason that if you don't hire a lawyer, you firstly end up saving a lot of money. 10 to 15,000 you would not have to cough up. And whenever a law student goes to a court of law and files a PIL, the courts lean in his favor, in his or her favor. For the simple reason that the court also wants to encourage those law students. So there are provisions under the law where you can argue the matter in person. Aap kabhi bhi agar kisi cheez se aggrieved hain, so you can argue the matter yourself. Right? And like I told you, in a PIL, you don't really require any, you don't have to prove locus standi. So if you are taking up a cause in public interest, that also means as a public, you are also aggrieved. So therefore, you can argue the case in person. So always argue the case in person. I'll just take a question a little later. We're just running short of time. I'll take it afterwards. Okay. So, argue the matter in person, and this will give you a lot of experience, which will really help you in life. So, go and argue the case in person. And I feel, you know, we study in one of the best law colleges, if not in the country, then at least in the state. All right, in this state. So, by the time you reach third year or fourth year or fifth year, you have a very sound understanding of the law, which is much better than many lawyers who practice in the court. So make use of this knowledge and go and argue the matter yourself. Right? So this is how you go about it. Then we come to how do you go and file the matter. So there's a process which you have to undergo. It's called notice, and file. And we just discussed about arguing in person. Yes. What is this? For example, your petition is now ready. Right? You can't just take it to a court of law. Right? You can't just take it to a court of law and ask the judge to hear it. It has to go through a process. So you go to the reporting section of the High Court or the Supreme Court, and then you give them your petition. Basically, what they do is, they rectify any mistake if there is in the petition. So for example, मान लीजिए आप कोई एक government order claim कर रहे हैं कि वो आपके fundamental rights infract कर रहा है. So let's say you forget to attach the government order. So this section will report to you that you have not attached the government order. Let's say you forget to sign somewhere. Let's say आपने affidavit नहीं डाली. So any mistake in your writ petition will be pointed out to you by this section. Once this is done, you have to give a notice to the lawyer who has to appear for the party whom you have impleaded. Now this is important. You just need to be aware of this. Now there are almost 10,000 lawyers in the Allahabad High Court or the Lucknow bench. Now how do you find the right lawyer who's to appear? Isn't it? So this you get to know from the reporting section itself. So, maan lijiye, I file a PIL against this college. Alright? So, somebody will be appointed by this college in the Lucknow High Court or the Allahabad High Court, and then you get to know the name of that person from this section. And then you can find that person in a court of law. I mean, kahin chamber hoga, pooch pooch ke aap jaiye, wahan pe unko do petition ki copy de dijiye, so that he can appear on the day when the matter is heard. So, this is how you give a notice to the lawyer who's supposed to appear on behalf of the party whom you have impleaded. Are you guys understanding?
Yes.
Then you have to file the matter. Filing is a little different. Yeah, you have to go to the registry, pay up the fee. It's just 100 rupees for a PIL matter, irrespective of the fact how many people file it. So it's just 100 rupees that you have to cough up. And let's say you file the matter on Monday. So it will be taken up on Wednesday, after 2 days. 2 days का time इसलिए दिया जाता है so that the judge can also read the file and come prepared. So 2 days time you're given, and yeah, your matter will be heard in a court of law. Whenever you argue, ask the court always to put the matter in the fresh category in case a future date is given to you, so that your matter gets heard with other matters which have been filed on the very same day. अगर आपको court में बहुत ज़्यादा रुकना पड़ेगा. So this is how you go about it. And yeah, do not worry about, see, like I was telling you, that you must always argue the case in person. Let's say aap do teen hearing pe gaye aur fourth hearing, fifth hearing pe nahi ja pa rahe hain. Let's say you have your exams, so you want to go back home, aap nahi ja pa rahe for some reason or the other. So what you can do is either hire a lawyer or just leave the case. Don't pursue it. Isse hoga kya? Either the court will itself hire a lawyer, or I mean appoint somebody as amicus, or the matter will just keep coming up and will not be taken, so pending chalta rahega, or the matter will get dismissed. That's all that can happen. Costs mujhe nahi lagta aap pe impose honge, law students pe to kabhi impose nahi hote, until unless you know it's a really frivolous petition. Say bhai isi type ka ki aap acche din ke liye you go and file a PIL. So costs will not be imposed upon you, and let's say in the eventuality costs do get imposed upon you because you have not turned up, so there is a provision under the rules of the court of recalling the order. So you file a recall application. What does this mean? Matlab jo order pass hua hai, last order, aap court se request karte hain to recall that order, and status quo maintain ho jata hai. So you can do this. I mean, in case costs get imposed upon you, mushkil se 100 rupaye, 500 rupaye, 1000 rupaye impose hoga aap pe for not turning up, and if you can advance cogent reasons as to why you could not turn up, I'm sure the court would recall its order. So this is what you can do, and this is how you go about filing a PIL. Alright, there's just one thought I want to leave you with. I'm sure you, all of you are being, I'll just come to you. Your question. All of you are being trained, so I'm sure PIL ek aisi cheez hai, PIL, RTI, ye sab aisi cheez hai, jo aap file karenge, kaafi. So, this is one thing I want to tell you, and which you will experience yourself once you start filing PILs. You see, every issue of national importance today is a sub judice matter. Aap koi bhi issue soch lijiye. Whether it's farmer suicide, women rights, child rights, labor rights, trafficking, koi bhi issue hai, it's a sub judice matter today. But even though the Supreme Court and the High Court is monitoring the matter, still things at the ground level do not change. Why do you think this happens? And the Supreme Court judges are not able to do it, what change can we bring about? Just think about this. So it's really difficult to, you know, consider PIL as a panacea for all ills. ऐसा आपको बताया जरूर जाता है कि आप PIL कर दो कुछ हो जाएगा, लेकिन ultimately things really do not work at the ground level. और इसके पीछे एक reason ये है कि the order that gets passed is passed to the same executive which is supposed to carry out the functions in the first place. So ultimately होता क्या है, ground level पे कुछ हो रहा है और court में कुछ और दिखाया जा रहा है. And the court also has its own limitations. तो compliance report भी मान लीजिए court कह रहा है file करिए आप, so there's very, it's not an accurate compliance report that gets filed. So these are certain shortcomings of a PIL which you yourself will experience once you enter into this area. And like I said, judges also have their own limitations, they have limited time. I mean, everything cannot be done by a judge in a democracy. As they say, you know, wise generals and wise judges, whenever they intervene for a very short period. Example, whenever a military coup takes place in the name of good governance, it has to be replaced by the democratic process. So similarly, judges also, when they intervene, they're able to intervene only for a limited period of time. You need support from the political executive. Aur jab tak wo nahi mil rahi hai, to things do will not change at the ground level. But this must not dishearten you. I'll just tell you, I'll just share one experience of mine and then I'll leave you guys. So, I'm not trying to sell myself away, but this one experience that I wanted to share with you and what I have been able to achieve through a PIL. Last year, summer vacation scheduling, the city to which I belong, that is Allahabad, witnessed around 7 to 8 acid attacks on women. So many women had got burnt and injured brutally, and this sent shockwaves across the city. I personally was very disturbed and did some research, and I found out that there were certain guidelines of the Supreme Court which were not being implemented. So I went to the court before the Chief Justice, and the court took a very serious notice of this lapse. Basically, wo guidelines aise the ki jo acid ki jo sale hai wo regulate ho jaye, so that it is not available to anybody who wants acid. Kisi ko revenge ke liye chahiye to nahi mil sakta hai. For example, it should not be sold to minors. किसी को सेल किया जाए तो उसकी आइडेंटिटी ली जाए, उससे पर्पस पूछा जाए क्यों ले रहा है वो एसिड. सो दिस इज हाउ सुप्रीम कोर्ट हैड ड्राफ्टेड सर्टेन गाइडलाइंस एंड ले डाउन सर्टेन गाइडलाइंस, एंड आई ऑल्सो ड्राफ्टेड सर्टेन गाइडलाइंस, एंड द कोर्ट इटसेल्फ गिव इट्स सजेशन. एंड विद इन 14 डेज द उत्तर प्रदेश कैबिनेट सैट स्पेशली फॉर दिस इशू एंड दे पास्ड अ सर्कुलर incorporating all these guidelines, and they became a law. And let me tell you, thank you. And let me tell you, I used to check the newspapers every day. For 8 months, no acid attack took place in my city. This is something you can achieve through a PIL, right? So don't get disheartened. You must go and file a PIL in a court of law and argue yourself. This is my sincere advice to all of you. You had a question and you had a question.
Yes.
I think we can. This is all for the session. Just questions, agar kisi ko puchna hai.
Sir, just a simple question, that reporting section of the court, like why is it necessary to report? Like, is it necessary that we need a lawyer? Yeah. We need a lawyer that will be appointed by the court in the.
No, but then who will come and argue for on behalf of, let's say, the municipality?
And what if we have a lawyer with us, then can we, will the lawyer be given by the court or can we take our own lawyer?
No, you can take your own lawyer also. I mean, firstly, you have to appoint a lawyer, right? And somebody will come from the other side. But let's say, aapke lawyer nahi turn up hote hain, ya aap lawyer nahi karna chahte hain, and you yourself go. So the court can also appoint an amicus.
Also in that case.
Yeah. So let's say the court needs some assistance. बहुत मान लीजिए बहुत बड़ा matter है, बहुत stakes involved है इसमें. तो court can always appoint an amicus or a senior advocate to assist. You
understand? Sir, as you said, it's always better to file an PIL in person.
Right.
My personal experience is like it was a petition was being